Last video, we have discussed the 8255 PPI, Programmable Peripheral Interface. In this video, we are going to discuss 8259 Programmable Interrupt Controller. The 8259 is a priority interrupt controller. It is used to expand the interrupt of 8085 or 8086 processor. 8259 is compatible with 8080 or 8085 or 8086 or 8088 processor. Okay, the 8259 is a device that is designed for use in real-time interrupt-driven microcomputer system. The interrupt controller can be used in cascaded mode to expand the interrupt up to 64 priority levels. The features of 8259 are: it can manage 8 hardware interrupts. The interrupt vector address is programmable. It can handle up to 64 levels of interrupts in a special configuration. The interrupts can be masked or unmasked individually. Then it provides the status of pending interrupt, masked interrupt, and interrupts being serviced. Then it supports internal priority resolver. It does not require any clock signal. Then fixed priority mode and rotating priority mode are supported. Then it can be programmed to accept either level triggered or edge triggered interrupt request. So these are the features of 8259 Programmable Interrupt Controller. This slide shows the block diagram of 8259. It consists of 8 blocks. The first one is data bus buffer. Second one, read write control logic. Third one, control logic. Fourth one, cascade buffer or comparator. Fifth one, interrupt request register IRR. Then sixth one, in service register, that is ISR. Seventh one, priority resolver, that is PR. Then last one is interrupt mask register. Let's see one by one. The first block, that is data bus buffer. So it is a tri-state bidirectional buffer. Data bus buffer is used to interface the internal data bus of the 8259 with the microprocessor data bus. Then it allows the 8085 to send control words to the 8259 and read status word from the 8259. It is a 8-bit data bus buffer. This buffer allows 8259 to send interrupt opcode and address of the interrupt service subroutine to the 8085 microprocessor. See the second block, read write logic. So this logic block has 4 signals. First one, read signal. Second one, write signal. Third one, A0. Then fourth one is chip select signal. Okay, the read and write signal act as control signals. So these signals are used to control all internal read or write operations. It contains the initialization command word, that is ICW register, and operational command word, that is OCW register, which store the various control format for the device operation. Then third block, that is control logic. It has 2 signals. One is INT signal, another one INTA signal. Okay, so it generates an INT signal and receives the INTA signal. An interrupt signal, that is INT signal, is an output signal. The INTA is the input signal. Okay, so these signals are used to control all the other blocks in the 8259. The next one is, that is the fourth block, is interrupt request register. IRR. The interrupt request register has 8 input lines starting from IR0 to IR7 for interrupts. When these lines goes high, the requests are stored in the register. The next one is interrupt mask register. It is a programmable register. IMR stores the masking bits of the interrupt lines to be masked. This register can be programmed by an operation command word, that is OCW. Okay. The next one is in service register, that is ISR. This register is used to store all interrupt levels currently being serviced. Each bit of this register is set by priority resolver and reset by end of interrupt command word. The next block, that is priority resolver. The priority resolver examines the interrupt request register and determine whether the interrupt signal should be sent to the microprocessor or not. So this is the function of priority resolver. Then the last block, that is cascaded buffer or comparator circuit. 8259 can be used in cascaded mode. So this section generates control signal necessary for cascaded operation. It also generates buffer enable signals. The cascade buffer or comparator is used to expand the number of interrupt levels by cascading two or more 8259s. So these are the blocks of 8259. The next one is pin diagram of 8259. Okay, the slide shows pin details of 8259. It consists of 28 pins, DIP, IC chip. So these are the pin details of 8259. So D0 to D7, okay, that is pin number 4 to 11, act as data bus buffer, bidirectional data bus. Then pin number 3 act as read signal, pin number 2 act as write signal, then pin number 1 act as chip select signal, then pin number 27 act as A0. A0 is nothing but command select address. Then CAS0 to CAS2, that is cascaded lines, pin number 12, 13 and 15 act as cascaded lines. Then pin number 16 act as slave program or enable buffer line. Then pin number 17 act as interrupt output signal. Then pin number 26 act as interrupt acknowledge input signal. Then pin number 18 to 25 called interrupt request inputs. So 8259 consists of 28 pins. All are fabricated on a single IC chip, that is called DIP IC. The first one, data bus buffer. These are bidirectional, tri-stated, buffered and non-multiplexed data lines. So data lines are used to transfer control and status and the interrupt vector information to the 8259 from the microprocessor. Okay, that is D0 to D7 lines. The next one, read-write logic, control logic. Read-write is an active, low control input lines. When read signal is low, enables 8259 to send various status signal on the data bus. When write signal is low, enables 8259 to accept command word from the CPU. So that is the function of read and write signal. Then A0. Then A0 is nothing but it is an address input line. It is used to select the appropriate control register. Okay. Then next one is CS signal. When it is low, enables the communication between CPU and 8259. So these are all read-write logic block signals. Okay, then next one, interrupt request register. So these interrupt requests are generated by the peripherals to inform the processor that some interrupt request has appeared using IR0 to IR7 lines. So the 8259 can receive interrupt signals from 8 different sources on the lines starting from IR0 to IR7. When these lines goes high, the requests are stored in the interrupt request register. The next one is interrupt mask register. So the IMR is used to disable or enable individual interrupt inputs. Each bit in this register corresponds to the interrupt input with the same number. The IMR operation on the IRR, interrupt request register. Then masking of higher priority input will not affect the interrupt request lines of lower priority. To unmask any interrupt, the corresponding bit is set to 0. Okay, so this is about IMR. The next one, in-service register. In-service register keeps tracks of which interrupt input are currently being serviced. Then for each input that is currently being serviced, the corresponding bit will be set in the in-service register. The corresponding bit will be reset in IRR register. So each of these three registers can be read as status registers. The next one is priority resolver. This logic block determines the priority of the set in the IRR. The highest priority is selected and strobed into the corresponding bit of the ISR during pulse. Next one, cascade buffer or comparator. So it is a bidirectional lines CAS0 to CAS2. So three lines CAS0, CAS1 and CAS2. It is a bidirectional lines. These lines are used in cascade mode only. In slave mode, these lines function as input lines. In master slave mode, these lines function as output lines. Then slave program and enable line. It is an active low bidirectional control line. It is used to select the line in buffered mode or non-buffered mode. Then interrupt operation. To implement the interrupt in the microprocessor should be enabled by writing the EI instruction, enable interrupt instruction. The 8259 should be initialized by writing control word in the control register. So the 8259 requires two types of control word. The first one is initialization command word, that is ICW, and second one operational command word, that is OCW. The first one, initialization command word. The initialization command word are used to set up the proper conditions and specify RST vector address. Then operational command word are used to perform functions such as masking interrupt, setting up status, read operation, etc. Okay, then after the initialization of 8259, the following sequence of events occurs when one or more interrupt request line go high. Okay, the first operation, the IRR shows the request. Then second operation, the priority resolver checks three registers, the IRR for interrupt request, the IMR for masking bits, the ISR for interrupt request being served. Okay, then third step, the microprocessor acknowledges the interrupt by sending INTA signal. Fourth operation, after INTA is received from the microprocessor, the appropriate priority bit in the ISR is set to indicate which interrupt is being served, and the corresponding bit in the IRR is reset to indicate that the request is accepted. Okay, then the opcode for the call instruction is placed on the data bus. Okay, so this is the fourth sequence or fourth step operation. In fifth step, when the microprocessor unit decodes the call instruction, it places two more INTA signal on the data bus. Okay, then in sixth step, when the 8259 receives the second INTA, it places the low order byte of the call address on the data bus And third, INTA, it places the high order byte on the data bus. In seventh step, during the third INTA pulse, the ISR bit is reset either automatically or by command word of ICW. Then the last step, the program sequence is transferred to the memory location specified by the call instruction. In this way, the 8259 works. Then, these are the operating modes of 8259. So, the various priority mode of operations are available in 8259. They are fully nested mode, then special fully nested mode, then rotating priority mode, then fourth one special masked mode, and last one is cold mode. The first type, that is fully nested mode, the 8259 operates in fully nested mode. It is also called default mode. In this mode, IR0 has the highest priority and IR7 is the lowest priority. When the interrupt is acknowledged, it sets the corresponding bit in ISR. So, this is about fully nested mode. Then, second type, that is automatic rotation mode. So, in this mode, a device after being serviced receives the lowest priority. The device just been serviced will receive the seventh priority. This mode is called as automatic rotation mode. Okay. So, the device just been serviced will receive the seventh priority. That mode is called as automatic rotation mode. Then, third type, that is specific rotation mode. So, in the automatic rotation mode, the interrupt request serviced is assigned the lowest priority. Whereas, in specific rotation mode, the lowest priority can be assigned to any interrupt input. That is IR0 or IR7. That fixes all other priorities. Then end of interrupt, that is EOI, command signal. After the completion of interrupt service, the corresponding ISR bit needs to be reset to update the information in the ISR register. So, this is called EOI command signal. It can be issued in three format. The first one is a non-specific EOI command. When this command is sent to 8259, it reset the highest priority ISR bit. Then second type, that is a specific EOI command. This command specifies which ISR bit is to reset. Then automatic EOI command. In this mode, no command is necessary. So during the third interrupt acknowledge cycle, the ISR bit is automatically reset. Okay, then the drawbacks are, the ISR does not have information about which ISR is being serviced. Thus, any IR can interrupt the service routine irrespective of the priority if the interrupt enable flip-flop is set. 8259 requires two types of command word. The first one is initialization command word. Second one, operational command word. 8259 can be initialized with four initialization command words. The first two are compulsory and the other two are optional based on the modes being used. See the flowchart. The first two command words are compulsory, that is initialization command word 1 and initialization command word 2 are compulsory. Okay, then first check the initialization command word 1, then initialization command word 2, then check the mode type, whether it is a cascaded mode or single operation. Okay, suppose if yes means go to the ICW3. Okay, suppose there is no cascaded mode means no need of ICW3. Directly moves to the ICW4. Okay, then check whether ICW4 is needed or not. If needed means then go to the ICW4 format. Okay, otherwise directly go to the interrupt request. Ready to accept interrupt request signal. Okay, so this is the flowchart for initialization command word. So this is the format of initialization command word. 1, it specifies A0 in addition with D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6 and D7. D0, D1 and D2 is nothing but vector address of 8085 microprocessor or any processor. Then D3 value is constant, that is 1. Then D4, that is LTIM, that is either level triggered mode or edge triggered mode. If the bit value is equal to 1 means that is a level triggered mode. If the bit value is equal to 0 means that is edge triggered mode. Okay, then D5. So D5 is nothing but ADI. So ADI means a call address interval. So if the bit value is equal to 1 means interval of 4. If the bit value 0 means interval of 8. That is the meaning. Then bit number 6, that is single. If the bit value is equal to 1 means single. Suppose the bit value equal to 0 means that is cascaded mode. 8259 can be operated in cascaded mode. Okay, then bit number 7, that is IC4, whether it is needed or no needed. Okay, suppose the bit value is equal to 1 means IC4 is needed. Suppose bit value 0 means ICW4 is not needed. So this is about ICW1 format. The next one is ICW2. A0 value is constant, that is 1, in addition with D0 to D7. So here ICW2 specifies a high order byte of the call instruction. Okay, see here D0 to D7 act as A8 to A15 interrupt vector address. A8 to A15 interrupt vector address. Then ICW3, that is master mode. Okay, so suppose cascaded mode means 8259 act as master mode. Okay, that is a first device master mode. Here A0 value 1, then D0 to D7 that specifies S0 to S7. If the bit value is equal to 1 means interrupt request register input has a slave. Suppose bit value 0 means interrupt request input does not have a slave operation. Okay, then fourth format, that is ICW3, that is in slave mode. A0 value 1, the remaining, that is a D0 to D7, out of D0 to D7, first 5 bits, that is a D0 to D4 bits, values are 0. The remaining 3 bits, that is ID0, ID1 and ID2 act as slave. So these are the initialization command word formats. The next one is operational command word. So this is the format of operational command word. So here A0 the bit value 1. Then the remaining bits specifies interrupt mask register. If the bit value 1 means it indicates maskable bit. Suppose 0 means mask is reset. Okay, that is the meaning. Then operational command word 2. Here A0 bit value 0. Okay, then the remaining bits values are D0 to D7, that is D7, D6 and D5 specifies 001 indicates non-specific EOI command. 011 specifies EOI command. 101 rotate on non-specific EOI command. 100 rotate in automatic EOI command mode. Then 000 indicates rotate in automatic EOI mode, that is clear. Then 111 indicates rotate on specific EOI command. 110 indicates set priority command. Then 010 indicates no operation. Okay, then D4 and D3 values are 0. Okay, the remaining 3 bits, that is L0, L1 and L2. So that is IR level to be acted upon. OCW3, A0th bit value 0, D7 value 0, D4 value 0, D3 value 1. Okay, then D6 is nothing but ESMM. Then D5, SMM. Then D2 is nothing but P. Then D1, RR. Then D0, RIS. Okay, see here. If the bit value, that is a D2 bit value, is equal to 1, that is poll command. If the bit value is equal to 0, no poll command. That is the meaning. Okay, then RR, RIS. Bit values, both bit values are 00 means no action. 01 also, there is no action. 10 condition, read IR register on next read pulse. That is the meaning. Okay, 11 indicates read IR register on next RD pulse. Okay, so 0001 condition, there is no action. 10 and 11, read IR register value on next RD pulse. Okay, then D5 and D6. Okay, one is ESMM, another one SMM. Both values are 0 means no action. 01 same operation, that is no action. 10 condition reset special mask. 11 condition set special mask. Let's see what is ESMM and SMM. ESMM is nothing but enable special mask mode. So when this bit is set to 1, it enables the SMM bit to set or reset the special mask mode. When ESMM 0, the SMM bit becomes don't care. Okay, then SMM is nothing but a special mask mode. If ESMM is equal to 1 and SMM is equal to 1, the 8259 will enter special mask mode. If ESMM is equal to 1 and SMM is equal to 0, the 8259 will revert the normal mask mode. When ESMM is equal to 0, SMM has no effect. So these are the details of OCW3, operational command word 3. Then additional features of 8259. One is interrupt triggering. Interrupt triggering is nothing but the 8259 can accept an interrupt request with either edge triggered mode or level triggered mode. Okay, that is called interrupt triggering. Then second feature, interrupt status. The status of the interrupt register, that is IRR, ISR and IMR, can be read. Then third one, poll method. The 8259 can be set up to function in a polled environment. So microprocessor polls the 8259 rather than each peripheral. So these are the additional features of 8259 programmable interrupt controller. These are the details of 8259 PIC programmable interrupt controller. I hope this video is useful. Soon we will meet in the next video. Thank you.